God is appearing, saying, call and train us to be reject God's way and worldly desire, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance, and the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us, deliver us from all lawfulness, and cleanse us for himself a people of his own, eager to do his will. When the kindness and generous love of God, our Savior, appeared, not because of any righteous deed we have done, but because of his mercy, he saved us through the death of the Word, and renewed by the Holy Spirit, whom he richly poured upon us through Jesus Christ, our Savior, so that we might be justified by his grace and become heir and hope of eternal life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Paul is reminding his companion and co-partner of the gospel that each one of us are preparing for one appearance, and that is our Lord Jesus Christ. But in order to be prepared, God sent his Son, who by his life he taught us how to live and how to reject evil, so that by doing so we'll be ready for the coming of the Jesus who promised, I will come again and take you to myself, so where I am, you also may be. He said that he had appeared to deliver us from our sinfulness and from those things, inclination that lead us to sin. And so, by doing so, we are eager to do what is good. And this is what's pleasing in his eyes. When the kindness and generous love of God, our Savior, appeared, when God himself, who sent his Son, he sent his Son to die on the cross, and through that death alone we are saved, not by any merits of each one of us. Jesus paid the full price for our sins, and because of that act that was past, is present, and will continue to be, he himself has done so, so that in God's mercy, he will give us the rebirth. That rebirth that after we are born in the world, we are reborn for God, and that in the blood of Christ, so that we will be cleansed from our original sin, and give us that grace that we need necessary to open the doors to receive more graces through the sacramental signs of the Church. He gave us also the renewal of the Holy Spirit, that Spirit that he prayed before he left. It's better I go, so the Father and I will send you the Holy Spirit, that Spirit that will teach you, that Spirit that will guide you, that Spirit that will remind you, that Spirit that will guard you, that Spirit that will renew you. And so he renewed us so that he himself, through Jesus Christ, we might justify. We will be justified from our evil, from our evil. And then, because we are justified and there are people of grace, then we are also waiting for that hope of his glory, where he is, because if we are cleansed, we are made children, we are living according to his way, we are eager for his coming, then we will join him in the promise of eternal life. May we, like St. Paul, as we remind his co-partner Titus, remember that our life on earth is a walk towards our destination. Everything that we accomplish on the face of the earth is nothing compared to that day when we will be found ready through the blood of Jesus Christ that we have been paid in, through our life to be led, pleasing to good, awaiting for his coming, so that empowered by the Spirit, rich in the grace of God, we will be now part if we are children on earth, by making known by our love that we are children of God, if we are so, we are then heir with Him. In His wonderful eternal life.